Ready to go, and this week it's all about R&B. Cheers, Dom. From the titles. There we go, ladies and gentlemen, the sensational Relo right there with Crazy Over You. And welcome to Reverb. And I can tell you that today is going to be an absolutely a fantastic show. If you haven't gathered already, let's find out who's on today's show.
Up and coming R&B star Dezmensa.
Last party's bottles, are you ready? Said I'm way too drunk to care.
It's funny how life turns out. I ask myself,
soulful singer songwriter Relo.
For a stranger, casually kicking it, chilling with my girls, and you walked right in.
There we go. What a show we have for you guys today. I'm bet you're glad you tuned in now, aren't you? Ladies and gentlemen, Dezmensa.
Just you.
There we go. Simply incredible. Dezmensa with Slow Love. Just a perfect, perfect song. Now, guys, I know how much all of you love Reverb. And if you can't wait till next Tuesday for your next dose of Reverb action, then you can check over to our radio show, which is on every Monday right here on stratcast.co.uk from 2:30. And on that show, you'll be joining myself, Max and Zach, where we'll preview the live TV show from that week. So if you want to find out a bit more information about the bands that are going to be on the TV show, then that's the place to be. So who's ready for some more music, guys? We all ready? Brilliant stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, Relo.
Thank you.
simply wonderful. That was amazing. Relo there with her track, absolutely loving it. Much more on the way from Relo and Dezmensa later on. But now we're going to have a little look at what goes on behind the scenes here at Reverb.
Producer for this year's series of Reverb. It's a daunting task and a huge team effort, so there's no way I could do it without every single person here on our course. Reverb is massive. It's the flagship show by the media department here at Stratford-upon-Avon College, and it's been running for 7 years now. The show began under the name And He Said You Can't Polish It in 2008, inspired by the old grey whistle test so that they could showcase bands. Then in 2009, they adopted the name Reverb, and that was also the first year they were able to stream over the internet. In 2010, the college moved to the Civic Hall in Stratford-upon-Avon and broadcast all of their shows from there. And this format continued until 2013, when they switched things up and did a 10.5-hour broadcast from Wellfest. Last year, they returned to the Civic Hall, and then this year, it's all changed again. We're showcasing two acts each week that fit a theme, and it's all happening in our TV studio here at college. The difference this time is that we're having a live audience in the studio with us every week, and then moving over to the massive Gordon Vallon studio for our finale on Saturday the 6th of June. As producer, you need to be well organised and willing to tell people what to do. I put together a running order and assign job roles, and then sort of oversee everything as it gets put together. In pre-production, we do as much planning as we possibly can to make life easier on the day of the show. I've been working closely with Jack, who is our very competent sound director, and he has produced an incredible sound design plan that we can adjust each week for the different setups. I have also kept in close contact with Naomi, who's brilliant, and she's been managing all of the talent for us. During the day before the show, we create the set, plan and rehearse all of the camera movements, and make sure everything is timed down to the millisecond. If we don't give the right timings to our PA, then we could come back to the studio at the wrong time, and that might throw off the entire show. It's a fantastic team. We're really lucky to work on such an exciting project, and everybody is doing an amazing job to produce what we hope will be the biggest series of Reverb ever. Make sure you keep watching.
There we go. So as you can see, a lot of effort goes in behind the scenes here at Reverb. Thank you to our producer, Amy O'Brien, for giving us a little guided tour there of Reverb and previous series. But as you can see now, I'm now joined by Relo. Thank you very much for joining us. And first of all, thank you for coming on the show. You happy to be here?
I am. Thank you for having me.
No problem at all. We're loving your track so far. More on the way from you later on. But what I want to know is your career all started when you were just 9 years old. Mm-hmm. So it's an incredibly young age to start. And I suppose you've grown up with music. Just how important is music to you?
Well, I didn't start music at nine, but I started singing at nine. My music career is important to me because it's what I love, it's my passion, but I started in primary school, so yeah.
Brilliant. Well, you mentioned your school there. I was reading upon your bio on your website, and it says that one of your school teachers actually pushed you to pursue sort of music. That must have been great to get sort of, you know, that praise from a teacher at such a young age. Do you think they helped a lot in getting you where you are now?
Well, yeah, because I started off with like a hobby, just sing around the house. And then when my teachers heard me, they decided to push me and actually make me realize that this is a big talent and you need to take it more seriously. That's when I started believing in myself more, I guess.
Brilliant stuff. Now, obviously, originally from South Africa, mm-hmm. and you moved over to the UK. Is there much of a difference in terms of the music sort of scene in South Africa to the UK? Do you think there's more opportunities or more platforms to promote yourself in the UK?
The music in South Africa is more like house based. At the moment, yeah. But when I grew up around a lot of blues, jazz music in my household anyway. Mm-hmm. But it's completely different. We love house music in South Africa, but I think it's pretty much similar, you know? Yeah.
Brilliant stuff. Now, that whole transition from moving from your home country to the UK, was that a difficult thing for you? Was it emotional, or was you excited to go on this new adventure to the UK?
I was excited until I moved here. Then it was difficult, you know, having to fit in and trying to find your way, make new friends. But I actually found my way through music. I joined a choir. That's where it all kind of pretty much started when I was 12 years old. I decided to do a lot of after-school activities, and one of them was music, and that's how I actually found my way.
Brilliant stuff. Well, I suppose you have a similar story to a lot of people. In fact, they all start singing young and they aspire to be something. To anybody watching at home who maybe wants to be in your situation one day, what advice would you give to any new artist?
I personally would say that get vocal training, because I got vocal training which was provided by the school. Thank you to St. Thomas Aquinas. But yeah, get vocal training and just go to any gigs, even if you're just watching, just go to the gigs, perform if you want to perform, and just interact with musicians. I think that's how you should start.
Good advice. Well, you mentioned gigs there. Have you got anything coming up soon or any new records you're working on that you want to tell people at home about?
At the moment, I'm working on my EP, just finalising the music, which is getting mixed and mastered, and then it's going to be released. I have a song that I want to push, a new single, just after Crazy Over You, and that's what I'm working on right now.
Brilliant stuff. Now, we have got one more track from you a little bit later on. What's this one called?
This one is called Blaze Up, which is one of my new songs that I'm performing for you guys today, which is the first time I've ever performed it, and it's included in my EP.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much again for coming on the show and speak to us today. Now, we're going to go stand over there in a second and listen to Derry perform another track for us. But guys, hopefully you're all loving the show at home. And if you are an unsigned artist, like Relo here, and you can take some of that advice that she's just told you and put it into action. But ladies and gentlemen, here on Reverb, Dezmensa.
I'll freak you right, I will. I'll freak you like no other man has ever made you feel. 7 o'clock on the dot. I'm in my drive time, cruising the streets. I need a real, really pretty little thing that's waiting for me.
There we go. That was simply incredible. The wonderful Dezmensa performing Usher's Nice and Slow. Absolutely loving that cover there. But now it's time for one of my favourite parts of the show. And this is where we go back in time to a previous Reverb series and check out one of the favourite acts from that. But this year, sorry, this time we're going back to 2014 with Suburban Doll. There we go, the amazing Suburban Doll performing on Reverb 2014. I was actually there in the studio and it was absolutely rocking. But anyway, I'm joined by Dezmensa. Dez, thank you very much for joining us and thank you for coming on the show. How are you doing? You okay?
I'm fine, thank you. Thank you for having me.
No problem at all. Delighted to have you here. Now, first of all, your sort of journey, musical journey, shot off to fame in The X Factor when you auditioned in front of thousands of people. And you later on joined The Risk later on in the series and actually you reached final in the end. Was that everything you anticipated from The X Factor? Did you ever expect to get that far?
Not at all. I just thought after my first audition, have a little bit of fun, get to boot camp and see where it goes from there. But it was a roller coaster. I was happy with where I got. So, yeah.
Well, you said it's a roller coaster and there's lots of drama on the way, particularly in your group, The Risk, because one of the members dropped out during the live show. Now, this is always a question that I've wanted to ask. I'm sure everyone's the same at home. Was that just for the cameras, or was that generally like a conspiracy in the group?
No, actually, it was. Like, he did actually want to go.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he just couldn't handle the hype, and everything was just going so fast for him, and he just wanted to leave, and we respected his decision then.
Oh, there you go. You've answered one of my questions that I've been wanting to ask for a long time. Now, we can't talk about you on The X Factor without mentioning a certain pretty lady. For those of you who didn't watch Dez's audition on The X Factor, let's have a look at this little clip.
There you Hello, Kelly.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. And who would you most like to impress today?
Kelly Rowland. Straight up, I love you, Kelly Rowland.
You're so cute, though. You're so cute.
She said, "Oh, cute."
Derry, this is a really good audition.
Seriously?
Yeah. Come on, we're serious right now.
I love you.
Can I get a kiss on my cheek?
So there we go. A great day. Not only did you get through your audition, but you also got a kiss off the wonderful Kelly Rowland. How is it watching that back? We saw your reaction.
Oh, thank God you cut it there.
Do you realise how lucky you are to get a kiss off Kelly Rowland?
Yeah, I do, actually.
Well, do you still feel the same, or is that just as you sort of got over it all, or no?
I'm not going to lie, I'll probably like to rewind that time and do it again.
I'm sure you would. I think everyone likes to be in your shoes, absolutely. Now, moving on to your solo career, you know, you've relaunched yourself, you're pursuing your solo career, going really well at the moment. Obviously, it's clear to see who some of your influences are. Obviously, you've done an Usher track there, and also people like Trey Songz as well. Have you always been into sort of R&B music, or is that something you just sort of adapted to suit your own voice?
No, I've always been interested in R&B music. I listen to MJ a lot as well. So he was one of my influences as well. So it's always been R&B.
Brilliant. Now, you're only young as it is, and you've already achieved quite a lot in your short career so far. Where would you like to see yourself in 5 years' time? Apart from with Kelly Rowland, of course.
In the charts, top 10, hopefully. Just trying to achieve my goals.
Brilliant stuff. Well, let's hope that will happen. And anything new coming up soon? Any gigs or any new releases you're working on?
Yeah, I've got a new single coming out, debut single, Way Too Drunk. I've got another single lined up called Want Me, which is hopefully just as good as Way Too Drunk, and see where that goes from there.
Brilliant. You're going to send that Want Me track to Kelly? No. I think you should.
Probably.
Yeah, it's a good idea. Anyway, you mentioned Way Too Drunk there. I've heard it already. Great track. Everyone loves it here in the studio. But for the people at home that might not have heard it, what's it about? Is there a message behind it?
Yeah, it's pretty much about getting drunk. And
obviously.
And having fun. In a club, wherever, just Brilliant. Getting drunk.
I think a song that everyone can relate to then, can't they, really? Well, we're going to go listen to Relo perform now. Thank you very much again for coming on the show and speaking to us today. Okay, over to Relo.
So dish right. I got everything you need tonight. Listen, boy, I'ma take you there to a place of no return. I'ma practice what I preach. And if you can't take the heat, then don't play with fire. So let it blaze up and burn this place down. I won't hold back, gonna let it go. Gonna stand and never show. I'ma let it roll out. So let it blaze up and burn this place down. I won't hold back, gonna let it go. Gonna stand and never show. I'ma let it roll out. So let it blaze up. I won't let these other girls who try take you away from me, away from me, away from me, away from me. I'll forever be the one you want. Hold you down for life. 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 So let it blaze up and burn this place down. I won't hold back if I let it go. God said I never shown. I'ma let them all out. So let it blaze up and burn this place.
You guys, but I think I've just discovered my new favorite track. Absolutely brilliant there by Relo. But unfortunately, we are getting towards the end of the show. But don't forget, if you like that track just as much as I did, then you can tell us all about it on Twitter at RBB_2015 or head over to facebook.com/RBB2015. The links are on your screen right now. But like I said, we are at the end of the show. But make sure you return next Tuesday right here on stratcast.co.uk, where it's our rock night. You're going to have to bring two pairs of socks, though, because they will rock them right off to your amazing bands right here in the studio. But now, from me, from Relo, from our amazing band here, our studio audience, and, of course, Dezmensa, and you guys at home, good night. Take it away, Des.
Way too drunk. Cheer.
Feeling faded, my head taking. Ciroc got me like I'm on a roller coaster. My mind's bugging, but I can take it. Eyes looking kinda heavy, but it's nothing. Wanna drink some, so let's get some. I don't waste no time, I'm already drunk. Get the bottles, there's a lot of them. Then we keep the party jumping to the morning. Let's take this party to the city.
Everybody in the city,
I'm let's pour these bottles, are you ready?
Are you ready?
Said I'm way too drunk to care right now. Said I'm way too drunk. All these ladies looking fly right now. Ladies looking fly right. Said I'm way too hot to think right now. Said I'm way too hot. Mr. DJ, turn my music loud. DJ, turn my music loud. Cause bouncing and I love it. Everybody on the dance floor buzzing. Bass dropping, body's locking. I'm a waste in the club cause we love it. Put your hands up and you try to two-step with it. You can do the doggy while you do it. Lift your drinks up cause you know the sky's the limit. We can do whatever till we finish. Let's take this party to the city.
Everybody in the city will
love it. Let's pour these bottles, are you ready?
Are you ready?
Said I'm way too drunk to care right now. Said I'm way too drunk.